In today's episode, we're going to take a look at a couple plugins for Cura. They might be helpful to you. So we're going to check them out right here on Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. Sometimes you get prints that curl up in the corner. This is a common 3D print problem. An easy solution is to put a brim around it. But what if you just want it in certain locations? That's where there's a plugin to put tabs in the corners. Go to Marketplace, and then there's the Tab Anti-Warping plugin. I installed it, so it shows install, but normally you click install and then have to restart Cura. And then it'll show up here on the left-hand menu. You can adjust the size of the tab and also the gap between the tab and the print. And to install it, you just go to where you want a tab and click where you want the center placed. So I'll put one at each corner of this CHEP cube. And now we've got those tabs in place. I can take a top view and you can see it's at each corner. I'm gonna hold down these corners or try to help hold down these corners from warping. There's one more step that isn't quite so obvious, and that's under supports. You need to check enable support brim. That's how this thing works. If you don't, let me show you what happens. I'll slice it and then look at preview. And look at it, just draws lines. They're very grid-like. They're not gonna do much at all. So you have to check enable support brim. Then when you slice it and we look at preview, you can see they're solid. They're gonna print solid and hold the corners down. One of my tabs wasn't centered to the corner. To move it, you just click on it and then use the move tool. And you can just drag it to where you want, just like any object in Cura. Real easy. Now, if you want to delete a tab, just click on it and then click on it a second time and it'll delete it. Just click on it, click a second time. Now, if you want to change the size, you can adjust the size here in the menu. And then when you click to put a new tab, it'll be that size. In this case, they're way too big. You can also adjust the gap between the tab and the print. I put it at 0.8 here, and it leaves this gap, which I don't understand the point of this because it's not holding down the corners. So I always use 0.2, that way it touches, holds the corner, but still easy to break away. And here's the way it will print. It'll print those tabs on the first layer and then build the CHEP cube up from there. I'm testing a really low-cost printer that doesn't have a heated bed, so these tabs may come in handy because I have seen some warping on the CHEP cube. And here's the print using the tabs. It's holding down really well. I stopped it after a couple layers, but it looks like it's working. I know this works on my Ender 3 as well, but I don't have as many problems with warping on that thing. But it definitely works here on this non-heated bed printer. Another plugin I've just started playing with allows you to export your Cura settings to an HTML file under the File, Save Project menu. I've installed this and I had to restart Cura, and I'll show you in a minute where it shows up. What I really like to do is easily compare my profile 0.2 to the standard quality Cura 0.2 profile. So I'm going to go File, Save Project, click Save, and then I'm going to put it into Downloads, but instead of .3mf, here's the .html. You select .html, give it the name. So I've got the standard selected right now, so I'll call it standard and save it. Now I'll go back and select my profile and do this again. File, save project, save, select HTML, and give it a different name. Just call it O2. And then save that as HTML file. So now with a browser, I can open it up. This is in Safari browser on my Mac. Open file, select the file. And now I can go through every setting that's in this. And it'll even tell me what Cura version was used. Now I can save those files. I can post them to my CHEP Club website. All kinds of things because now it's an HTML format. I can also open those in other programs like Excel. So I can take those two and then open them in Excel and then combine them into columns here. I have standard on the left and my CHEP version on the right. And then I can scroll through and see the differences. I highlighted them in yellow here, so I just went through the file to see the differences of what they're doing and what I'm doing, and maybe I'll learn something just by looking what they did versus what I did. So it's very, very handy to be able to export these as a .html file. So there you have a couple plugins to play with. Check them out and let me know what you think of them in the comments below. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.